Hivestorm! Volcus is a planet of Stygian darkness and fiery illumination, a place of sprawling city plexes and nightmarish industrial wastes. Famed by the titanic orbital defense cannon, which is worshipped and revered by the loyal Imperial citizens of the planet, Volcus is under attack by the fifth sphere expansion of the Tau Empire. Deploying from Orca dropships, teams of insectoid Vespid Stingwings look to cut off reinforcements from reaching the Great Gun, forcing the planet into submission. But swooping down from the skies come kill teams of Tempestus Aquilons, elite Imperial soldiers who are renowned for being uncompromising and merciless killers. Can the Aquilons destroy the Vespid, or will the Great Gun's silence doom Volcus? It's time to find out on Battlefield. We're here on the weapon planet of Volcus for a game of Kill Team. I'm super excited. It's my brave and noble Tempestus Aquilons up against your foul Xenos Vespid Stingwings.
Yeah, that's right. We've been outfitted by the Tau Empire with fancy new equipment, which we can't wait to introduce to your Imperial lapdogs.
Yeah, bring it in, man. Let's go. I can't wait. We're playing from the preliminary ops mission pack from the core book, and we've got the secure crit op, haven't we? How's that work?
That's correct. There are three objectives on the board, which our operatives can secure, and they remain under our control until secured by an enemy operative.
Okay, and of course, securing them and holding them at the end of a turning point gets us victory points, which is what the game's all about. But there's another way to score victory points, right?
Yeah, and it's one the Vespid are a big fan of. It's called Kill Ops, and here we get victory points just for eliminating our opponent's operatives.
Oh, and this way, every two models we kill is going to score another victory point.
Yeah, that's true. It's going to be bloody.
It really is, isn't it? Oh, let's go, man. My kill team of battle-hardened Tempestus Aquilons are dropping into the heart of enemy-held territory on Volcus, all guns blazing. My Tempestor leads their kill team into the thick of battle. More than just a warrior, they also possess the tactical and strategic knowledge to direct their squad's efforts. The Grenadier is the explosive specialist of the kill team, able to cripple enemy fortifications with a well-placed melter bomb or blast enemies apart with a hurled crack grenade. Wielding hot-shot dual las pistols, gunfighters lay down hails of close-range firepower, cutting down foes with terrifying aggression and accuracy. A single burst from a gunner's plasma carbine can bring down a rampaging Genestealer Patriarch or Heretic Astartes Legionary, so Vespid Stingwings should be no trouble. Whether lining up the killing shot to complete an assassination mission or picking off elite enemy operatives in aid of their comrades, a marksman provides invaluable long-range support to their kill team. A precursor specializes in dropping in as swift and stealthily as possible, then knocking out or distracting the most dangerous ground defenses to help their comrades deploy unscathed. A servo sentry is a combat mechanoid that drops via grav impeller motors and provides Aquilon kill teams with fire support from its hotshot volley gun. Tempestus Aquilon troopers are clad in resilient carapace armor and wield powerful hotshot las carbines. These rigorously trained warriors boast discipline, accuracy, and resilience. The Tempestus Aquilons descend to the kill zone, dropping in from Valkyrie gunships. Reinforcements will be arriving throughout the skirmish on the drop markers, ready to overwhelm the Vespid. Tempestus Aquilons use their grav-chutes, which emit a repulsion field, which they utilize to drop down from high ground safely at a measured pace. For my equipment, I'm taking two from the universal equipment points. Some light barricades and some smoke grenades should help me protect my Aquilons from that neutron fire. But to spice things up, I've gone for Tempestus daggers for my whole kill team. I know those Vespid want to close in, and a remote overseer to help me get the drop on those aliens.
Kill teams of Vespid Stingwings surge into the fight upon humming wings, their deadly neutron weapons thrumming with radioactive power. It is the task of the strain leader to interpret the commands of their kill team's handler, and then a longsting employs their power of flight to swiftly relocate between ideal vantage points, making for an elusive and deadly sniper amidst the dense terrain. The Shade Strain's ghost rig hides them behind a veiling stealth field that smothers sound, sight, and even energistic impressions as they move into position, before striking with their potent neutron sting. A Vespid Skyblast wields the recently developed neutron grenade launcher to great effect. The munitions detonate with a large blast radius, but even those who survive will likely succumb to its deadly radioactive aftermath moments later. The Swarm Guard's Tau Flamer projects roaring jets of chemical fire that can incinerate groups of foes, spreading panic and agony amidst enemy ranks. The bulk of most Malkor kill teams is comprised of warriors. Resilient, swift and strong, they're natural combatants, bearing murderous firepower in the form of their iconic neutron blasters. The harmonic thrumming of a Vespid's wings resonates within the crystals of its weapon, meaning that any dynamic movement serves to neutron charge the atom-stripping energy it unleashes to devastating effect. The Tau have developed ingenious neurological links through the use of communion helms, through which they're able to maintain a modicum of control over what are an instinctively unruly and ferocious species. The Vespid Strain Leader keeps constant communication with the Tau Overseers. For this mission, I'll be using the commune ability to make sure I have access to the Aerial Agility Strategy Ploy for free while my Strain Leader is on the table and not in combat. With their wings granting them the innate ability to fly, Vespid are able to circumnavigate even the tallest and densest terrain with impunity. For equipment, my Vespid will be enhanced with all four of the available faction stimulants, giving them an extra burst of speed, ensuring clarity of communication, discipline once the fighting starts, and that they'll show no mercy to their prey in combat. So now it was time for us to deploy our operatives. Nick had some light barricades to set up, but then it was on to me to set up the first third of my kill team. I set up three Vespid warriors and my oversight drone. I spread them out along my kill zone to keep my options open. It's time for Nick to deploy. He deployed his first third, including his Tempestor and his marksman. He deployed his servo sentry too in the bottom right of the board. I'd seen where Nick was starting to deploy, so it was time for me to bring in some of my big guns. My Long Sting and my Sky Blast I set up on one side of the board, whereas it was time for me to drop my Shade Strain on the top right.
Then it was time to deploy my Gunner, my Grenadier and another Trooper, but here instead on the drop zone, I'm deploying them to the side of the kill zone. They'll be coming down from drop insertion later on, but I have put down one of my drop markers right here. Josh then deployed his next group. A Warrior came down first, followed by his leader, the Strain Leader, and a Swarm Guard too. For my last group, I had another Trooper, my Gunfighter and the Precursor, but again, they're not going to be deploying in the kill zone, but instead placed to one side. They'll arrive via drop insertion later on, but I will place down a second drop marker in my drop zone. Just it's time for the first initiative roll. Here we go.
All right, let's go.
And I'm taking it, and you know what? I want the jump on you, foul Xenos, so I'm going to go first over this side.
All right.
Let's go, man.
Let's have a great game.
Next, it was time for Josh to roll for his communion points. Now, these are special points used exclusively by the Vespid Stingwings to ignore their animalistic base instincts and do exactly what their Tau commanders tell them to do. Josh has got the neurostimulant equipment here, so he rolled 2d3 and picked the highest. Thanks to the Tau oversight drone, he added one onto that as well, for a total of 4. Josh is going to have to use these very carefully in the kill zone if he wants to do well. So, time for the gambit step, and up first, I used rapid insertion on this trooper to move him towards the objective here.
I spent one command point on airborne predators, and Nick responded by using Eye Above, meaning these Vespid would be marked with a detected token, perhaps making their shooting a bit less effective.
Josh has used the Strain Leader's commune ability to activate the Aerial Agility Strategy Ploy for free. And finally, I moved my drop markers forwards towards the Vespid and the objectives. So onto the firefight phase, and I have the initiative, so I'm going first. And I'm going to put the kill and kill team straight away,
okay,
as my servo sentry is going to activate here, Josh. And it's going to go into engage immediately, make a little dash action like so, and pop its big gun around the corner at that Vespid warrior who's in the open. That's how it is, man.
Imperium getting the servo turret to do their dirty work for them.
Absolutely.
I see how
here
it
is. Here we go. Its hot shot volley gun is going to take a focus shot at your Vespid warrior there. 4s to hit. Here we go. Okay, so that's a pretty good shot there from Servo Sentry. However,
yes,
your warrior is obscured by this heavy barricade here. So because you're obscured, I don't get any crits. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to turn those crits into normal hits. And because you're obscured, I lose a normal hit as well. So it's going to be 3 hits going through.
Okay. All right, so that turret's coming at us. It looks like we're going to need 5+. Oh, and we get 1.
You got
okay,
1 there.
Cool,
that's
cool.
Pretty good.
But we also have a little trick up our sleeve. It's called Aerial Agility.
Nice.
So we actually can take one of these damage rolls that's going to be inflicted upon us and see if we can get another chance at saving it. On a 5, we can negate the damage.
You do
we
as
do.
Well.
Very nice
good.
One.
You are still taking 3 damage on that best.
Yeah, we absolutely are. Okay. That servo sentry nearly annihilated one of my Vespid warriors, so we're going to have to do something about it. My Vespid Longsting moved on to engage and flew up to the top floor of the building. I took aim at the servo sentry, though it did cost me a communion point. My Vespid Long Sting now has vantage on that servo sentry, so we're going to fire our neutron rail rifle with a standard profile.
Nice.
Now, we're on vantage, so we actually get to keep one dice because the weapon is accurate.
Nice.
And we've got these three, and we're going to need to roll fours to hit.
Okay, so you've missed twice, I'll take that.
But, like I said, we do have sneaky Xenos tricks, and because of our airborne predators rule, we're going to get to re-roll this for balanced.
Okay, so you got three hits through, which is pretty good for your sniper there. I've got three defense dice.
It's going to be two defense dice, because of our neutron charge rule.
Well, okay, well, I've got two defense dice then. I will retain one, as I'm in cover.
Of course.
But I will roll the other one. Three plus save.
Let's see what you get.
I passed that save, so I've taken two off, but you did still get one through, and that's going to be three damage, is it?
It's going to be four damage.
Four damage! Ugh, that's a big shot!
So after all that, I got to put a neutron fragment token down on the servo sentry. Nick's Tempestor gives his marksman plus one APL before moving into the building and into cover. Seeing this, I move my Skyblast up onto a vantage point as well, staying in concealed to get some damage in later.
So it's time for my first model to come down into the kill zone via my drop insertion rule. Here I've chosen a trooper to lead the way. Dropping down near this drop marker, thanks to swift landing, I can arrive up to 4 inches horizontally away from that marker, and he lands at the top of this building on this vantage point. And I'm going to use this last carbine and blow away your accursed shade string.
Oh, well, their ghost rig says you can't target them.
And that's why it's accursed. I hate that thing so much. Fine, I'll kill another alien. I'm going to go for that one I've already shot before. Now, because I'm on the vantage point and it's so high up, it's accurate too. So I've already got two hits, and I'm going to roll for the other two.
Oh, this was not a good day for them to leave without their ghost rig.
And, oh, it's going to be a one more. So, three hits going through against that Vespid Warrior.
Okay, so we've got three saves of 5+.
And, oh, he's going to save two of them as well.
Two of them. We've got aerial agility to attempt to save that damage.
Don't you dare.
He saved it as well.
This guy's taking everything. What a hero.
Oh, my goodness. I move one of my Vespid Warriors up the board. Nick's gunner, who is still up in the sky waiting to deal damage later, simply expends his activation. With a reposition and a dash action, I'm able to get my Vespid Strain Leader into a great position over here.
My Grenadiers arrive via drop insertion down by objective number one, and they're going to throw a frag grenade at that accursed Longsting who's sticking its rifle through the window. And he's hitting on a three or more because he's super good with grenades.
All right, let's see what you get.
It's not a great roll, but I've got two hits there.
So we have three defense dice, and we're going to be able to retain one of them for being in cover.
You're not, because the frag grenade has saturate, so ignores that completely.
Oh no, we're going to have to roll these all by ourselves.
Yep.
All right, well, we need some five pluses, so let's see them.
You've got five pluses.
We don't get any. So two successful hits are going through. That means two chances to save with aerial agility.
Nah, you'll
fail
them both,
mate. So we're looking for fives.
Fail them both. You have failed them both.
Oh, we didn't get any.
So four damage going through onto your long sting. Thanks to the blast rule on that frag grenade, the sky blast next to the long sting was taking hits as well, even though it's concealed. I rolled up, did well, but the aerial agility has stopped any damage going through again. Josh then took his Tau Oversight drone and moved it into the stronghold underneath the Sky Blast. Then my Precursor activated. Remember, they're in reserve, waiting to come down via drop insertion. Instead of activating them though, I just expended them. They're waiting for later.
I move my Vespid Swarm Guard into the top right building, ready to ambush any unsuspecting Tempestus Aquilons later. Nick expends his gunfighter next, biding his time up in orbit. My next Vespid Warrior moves round the top left building and gets into a great position.
Then I activated this trooper on the left-hand side of the kill zone. Now they're going to stay where they are for now, playing the waiting game. Josh, though, is being far more aggressive. This Vespid Warrior has gone into engage, jumped out into the middle of the board, and aimed his neutron blaster at my Grenadier. Josh got some incredible rolls, and my saves really let me down. He's been blown apart by the radiation weapon. That's first blood to the Vespid Stingwings. Then one of my troopers waiting in reserve came down and arrived via drop insertion into this stronghold next to this drop marker. I aimed my last carbine over the side of the building at that Vespid Warrior who just took down my Grenadier. I didn't get so lucky here, but I've done three damage.
I activate my final Vespid Warrior and switch to engage, taking aim at Nick's trooper on the top of the building. It cost me a communion point because it's not the closest operative, and because of some rolls that aren't really great or good, I don't do any damage.
Josh, my last operative is my marksman here, who's going to make a move and a dash action, climbing up the side of this building here and into position. Now, if you remember, they are on plus one APL from earlier on, and with that last APL, I'm going to pop a smoke grenade right next to him, right there, so that he's protected from your shooting the next turning point.
And to finish off the turning point, I move my Shared Strain up next to my warrior.
Well, it's the end of the first turning point, and of course we can't score crit ops yet, and we haven't scored anything on the kill points either, so it's nil-nil for now. Turning point one has seen the strategies of both kill teams come to light, as the Tempestus Aquilons are taking up position on the kill zone to try and take those objectives, but Josh, with those Vespid Stingwings, is being super aggressive. It seems early doors, like he's going for those kill ops.
All right, initiative for turning point two.
All right, let's see who's got it.
It's going to be you. You've got it.
Ooh, okay. Well, I think I would like to go first then.
No worries, man.
We both gain a command point, though Nick gains an additional one because he goes second. Then we both ready our operatives, and Nick has to remove a drop marker. He chooses to remove the one on the left. Now it's time to generate communion points, but between my neurostimulants and my oversight drone, I ended up with three. Eating away at the servo sentry, the neutron fragment does three damage. Nick's smoke grenade is also going to stick around for one more activation. Aerial agility is still online thanks to commune, but here I choose to spend two command points on airborne predators and sting. It's going to get brutal this turn. Nick uses drop and secure on objective two. He then spends a further two command points on sudden offensive and maintain momentum. Using drop insertion, Nick is able to move his drop marker up towards objective two. Onto the firefight phase, my Vespid warrior uses convergence stimulant to secure objective 3 without spending a communion point. I'm going to put this little blue dice on it, just so I remember. Then I do spend a communion point as my warrior takes aim at Nick's trooper. It's worth it though, we get 2 crits and leave the trooper on 1 wound remaining. At the end of this activation, Nick's smoke grenade disappears.
So my marksman's going to take aim from the vantage point here and shoot into your Vespid warrior down there. I'm going to stay and conceal because it's a concealed shot. And as I'm on a vantage, it's accurate one. So my first shot just hits.
Oh my
God. See what the others do. Here we go.
All right.
So I've got no crits on the roll there, but thanks to maintaining momentum, my gun has the severe rule. So I'm going to take that normal hit and turn it into a crit hit on a 6. And that means as well, the gun is devastating 3. So just take 3 damage immediately. And then take a bunch of saves.
Okay. So already we've gone down to 3 wounds and we're in cover so we can retain one of those saves. So we need 5 pluses to try and save this guy's life.
I mean, good luck. you've done all right.
We've saved one.
So Josh, that's 2 hits going through after your saves. Even your aerial agility won't save you here. That Vespid's had his head blown off its shoulders.
Yeah, not this time. This guy's going back to the greater good.
My marksman's got 1 APL left, Josh, and I'm going to use the other smoke grenade to be popped right there. Just fighting out of smoke.
You love it. I mean, like, where did that shot come from? So it's time for some combat, and our Vespid warrior fancies introducing that trooper to some claws.
Yeah, okay, fair enough. Let's go for it, man.
All right.
I'm using my Tempestus daggers over here, so
we've got 3 attacks.
Oh, it's okay. Not a bad roll for the Tempestus side over here.
It's pretty good, isn't it? So not only have we gotten 1 hit, we've gotten 2 crits because of Sting.
Yeah,
that's
nice.
Going to deal some extra damage over to your warrior.
So you're going to go first, of course, because you're the active player. Which of these dice are you going to use first?
Of course. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use one of my critical successes.
Yeah.
And because of the shock rule, that's going to get rid of one of your successes as well. Yes.
How much damage is the crit doing?
It's going to be 4.
Okay, he's down to half health already. That's not great. Because of that crit there, I don't think there's a way that I can survive this. So I will just fight for the Emperor and deliver you 3 points of damage out of spite before I assume the crit gets delivered.
Of course. Yeah. Well, we'll take that 3 damage, but you'll soon be feeling the Vespid sting as we crit you again for another 4.
Been slain.
2 kills for the Vespid, and we're moving up to kill grade 1, which is most importantly going to get us victory point.
Don't worry, I'm right behind you. An exciting part of this edition of Kill Team is the Kill Ops. We'll go up on this kill grade chart for slaying enemy operatives based on how many there were at the start of the battle. Now we both have 10, and that means every time Josh and I kill 2 miniatures, we go up 1 kill grade, earning ourselves a victory point. And Josh has done exactly that. He's got 2 kills, he's got 1 victory point. At the end of the battle, whoever has a higher kill grade earns another victory point as well. We're really putting the kill back in Kill Team. This injured trooper is going to shoot down at your Vespid here. He's on a vantage point, so I'm going to get 1 automatic hit, but 3 more hitting on 4s because he's injured. Here he goes. And oh, look at that.
Ooh.
It's going to be a crit and a hit. You know, I'm still being affected by my sudden offensive, so I'm going to re-roll this one as well. Oh, it's still a 1. But you are facing a crit and a hit.
I absolutely am. So that's going to be 3 defense dice from me, and let's see what we can do.
Oh no! Oh, he's in trouble.
Even my aerial agility won't save me on this one.
No, he's dead. Get him off. That's my second kill as well. That's me on kill grade one, so I'll get a victory point two.
Oh, you really were Quillos behind me. All right, let's see if we can't increase that lead.
Josh's Vespid Warrior has charged into my troop on the left of the kill zone here, and thanks to the Sting strategy ploy that's in play right now, has the shock ability. That means he's managed to take away some of my hits and also done some damage himself. That trooper is still alive, but just. In response, the Tempestor, the leader of the Aquilons, has added the support rule onto that trooper to give them extra APL to hold objective number one later, then taken out their chainsword, revved it up, and charged into combat with that Vespid Warrior to cut the Xenos down.
Let's have a combat, here we go.
Okay.
Oh, it's good news for
okay.
me. Now, thanks to sudden offensive, I'm re-rolling this one as it's balanced.
Okay.
Still a miss though, but that's still right. gonna be a crit and two hits. So these are our hits, Josh. I'm going to take this crit here and just do you 5 points of damage to
Ooh,
your poor Vespid Warrior.
Straight away. Yeah. Oh my goodness. Right, that's going to drop me to four. So it looks like that with my dice, I'm not going to be able to come out of this alive.
No.
But what I can do is I can deal you some damage with our claws.
Yeah, fine. Whatever, that's fine. But I will just then take my one of my other dice here and just cut that Vespid in half. It's gone.
All right, it's time for my Vespid Long Sting, and I'm going to take aim at that trooper. It's going to cost me a communion point, but I really think we can take him out.
Oh, that's two crits, right?
Yeah, and they're both devastating, so he's just dead.
No saves here, man. He's had his head blown clean off.
Seeking revenge, Nick activates his trooper on the left, moving him forward and taking aim back at the long sting.
Oh, it's a pretty saucy roll
as
well.
That's a nice
Josh.
Roll.
That is three hits and a crit. I'm going to leave those dice as they are as well.
Yeah,
so,
of course.
What have you got to say about that?
So I believe I'm going to be able to retain one dice
for
cover.
Sure. Yep.
So we'll just have one of those. And we're going to try roll some five pluses.
You'll need
see
them.
If we can save his life.
I know,
oh,
he's bang in trouble. So Josh, you've managed to save one of those there, but the crit and the two hits will go through.
I think, my goodness.
Even with any agility, mate, that's going to be one dead Vespid.
Yeah, absolutely. So our long sting has stung his last. Nick has actually killed enough of my Vespid to move up to kill grade two. This earns him another victory point. But the escalation continues as my Vespid Skyblast annihilates Nick's trooper. I get to place a neutron fallout token, and this is actually enough to move me up a kill grade two. We're on two victory points.
Then the plucky Servo Sentry opened up with its hotshot volley gun into the Sky Blast in this building over here. Now, it was obscured by the heavy terrain and in cover as well, so I had to get really lucky to do any damage at all, but what a good boy. He's done a massive amount of damage to that Sky Blast and left it injured. Josh then moved his Swarm Guard up here behind this heavy terrain on the Stronghold, hoping to take Objective 2 later on, but I'm going to get the drop on him here, literally, as my Precursor comes down by my drop marker near Objective 2 and secures it for the Tempestus Aquilons.
Next is time for the Vespid Strain Leader. He moves into the bottom right building and takes aim at Nick's Precursor. It's not a great shot from me though, and it only does 3 damage. Nick's Gunner finally arrives in the kill zone and takes aim at my Vespid Strain Leader.
Oh, Josh, I've completely whiffed. I've got to miss 3 times. But that 6 is going to be a critical hit.
Right.
It's piercing 1, so it's minus 1 defense dice.
Okay.
You can retain 1 from cover, which means if you can just save 1, you can stop that plasma gun blowing that Vespid's head off.
Right, well, you better believe I'm retaining 1, so let's look for a lucky save here. Hey,
he's got it as well. So combine both saves together, stops the crit, and you got away with that. But it's not all, because when I supercharged it, that gun gets hot.
Oh.
Anything but a 1 or a 2.
Right.
Oh, he's got away with
it
this time.
He's okay this time. My Vespid Shade Strain just goes into this building here. The sneakiness continues.
Then it's time for my last operative waiting in reserve to come down onto the board. This is my Gunfighter. Now here, instead of going down by one of the drop markers, I chose instead to put them down in my drop zone, here on the right of the board, behind this Stronghold. They've landed and used a dash ability to move up as well. My aim here is to go for objective number 3 and sneak in there under Josh's nose. Lastly, Josh activated his Tau Oversight drone and moved it up here next to his Skyblast. So that's the end of the turning point, and if you have a look at the board here, you can see the Imperium have claimed 2 objectives, and you've claimed only 1 for
yeah,
greater
only
good.
Yeah, only
it's
one.
For the lesser good, in fact. I'm going to get 2 victory points here, you'll get the 1 on to turning point 3.
Yeah, let's see what happens. At the end of the turning point, it's going to be 4-3 to the Tempestus Aquilons. So it's the end of turning point 2, and we've suffered some casualties on the Vespid side, but we're in a good position. I've got several of my operatives in that bottom right building, and that's going to give us a great chance of snatching that middle objective.
Just before the next turning point kicks off, I wanted to take a moment to let you know where you can find more battle reports just like this one. If you're enjoying this tabletop action, you can find over 100 episodes of Battle Report right now on Warhammer Plus, covering loads of Games Workshop's game systems. But that's not all. You'll get exclusive access to Warhammer animations and shows, explore the background of our universes with Lore Masters, and get the lowdown on how to paint exceptional miniatures with Citadel Color Masterclass. You'll get access to fantastic apps to really enhance your gaming experience, the chance to enter competitions to win some fantastic prizes, and access to exclusive miniatures too. So, don't delay, operative. Subscribe to Warhammer Plus today. There's a link down in the description. Okay, on with the game.
It's turning point three, it's super close, and it's time for initiative. Let's do it.
Ah, it's yours, you've got it!
Alright, we're
gonna take it, right?
Yeah, we're definitely going first. Nick removes his last drop marker. I get 4 communion points, and the servo sentry takes 1 point of damage from the neutron fragment. Nick's smoke grenade is gonna disappear after one activation. My Vespid strain leader is still alive, so aerial agility is still online. This time, Nick just uses one command point on maintain momentum. That means he's got 2 command points ready to go at any time, so I'd better keep an eye out. I've spent 2 command points though, one on Sting and one on airborne predators. So we're kicking off the firefight phase, but I'm going to activate the oversight drone. Now, relaying instructions from Tau High Command, we're going to be activating aerial guidance. The drone's going to stay right there, and it's over to you.
My marksman is now free of the smoke around him. He's going to aim his long lance down at this Vespid warrior holding objective number 3. So prepare to receive the Emperor's judgment.
You're going to try and claim that objective. I see,
it's
going to
be mine.
Doing.
It's going to be mine. Now, I'm on the advantage point, so I'm going to get 1 free hit. And now I'm going to roll the rest of them, hitting on a 2 or more. Eat this, Xenos.
Oh, it's going to be a whole bunch of hits, Josh.
It's going to be 1 crit and 3 hits. Now, also, this weapon is devastating 3, so you're just taking 3 wounds immediately for me just rolling that crit.
I'm going to retain 1 save for cover.
Yeah, you'll need it.
and we're going to look for some 5 pluses.
Oh, he saved 1.
We have.
Pretty good. It's... So, Josh, your 2 saves take away this one and this one, but that leaves the crit and the hit coming through for 3 apiece. That is a total of 9 damage in 1 shot from the sniper. He's just blown that Vespid's head clean up the building.
Which is leaving that objective completely undefended.
Mine. It's mine.
Making a dash action with my Sky Blast, it's time to fire back at that marksman. So guided by the Tau Empire, we're going to fire the Sky Blast into that marksman. We want a little bit of revenge.
Yeah, fair enough.
Oh, oh no!
That is bad news. Josh, that is 2 crits, but the 2 misses, you can reroll one balanced, right?
I can, so let's see if we can't make that an additional.
You cannot,
but
the 2 crits are a real problem.
Absolutely. Those crits are devastating, so that's going to be 4 damage immediately.
That's a problem for the marksman. Got 2 saves to make because it's piercing, because it's a neutron weapon.
Of course.
I can't retain for cover because your drone gave him the aerial guidance. So basically, I've got to roll 6 live on battle report to keep my marksman alive. Here it goes.
No, it wasn't close.
He's been utterly blown away by your huge grenade.
And we're going to replace that marksman with a nice neutron fallout.
I don't like that at all. Then it was time to enact a fiendish plan with my gunfighter on the right of the kill zone. They've moved and dashed towards objective number 3, but I've got no APL left to do the mission action secure. Here, though, I've got a command point. I use the firefight ploy Tempestus Exemplars and use a mission action for free. Boop! Objective number 3 belongs to us. Josh immediately reacted with the Shade Strain, who's charged into my gunfighter in objective 3, using a communion point to do so because it wasn't the nearest target. The gunfighter here is going to have to defend itself in combat, but they've done their job.
The Shade Strain's going to attack with his claws, and we've still got Sting activated, so it's going to be fairly lethal.
Pretty good. Well, I'm going to be using the Hotshot Las Pistols at point blank range for the gunfighter. Here we go, man, let's go.
Okay, oh, that's a great roll from the gunfighter over here.
So our roll wasn't great, but because of our aggression stimulants, we do have the ceaseless rule. So I'm going to take all these 2s and re-roll them.
Yeah, all right, fair enough.
All right, there we go. We've got 2 crits and a hit.
That's pretty good.
Mm-hmm. And they have the shock rule. So we're going to use one of these crits to deal you damage and get rid of one of your successful dice.
Yeah, very good, sir. That's pretty good. I've got to stop that crit of yours, so I'm going to use my crit, Josh, and block yours out of the way here, giving me a chance to survive.
So he may yet live. Right, well, in this case, we are they don't call us the aggressive species for nothing, so we're going to deal you some more damage.
So I'm taking 7 points of damage.
Yeah.
Okay, fine. Well, I will deliver back to you 6 points of damage. Next up, that brave servo sentry, everyone's favourite gun turret, fired up at the Sky Blast in this building over here, but it was injured, it's obscured, it was behind cover, it's done no damage at all.
The Vespid Swarm Guard moved up and immolated Nick's precursor. But thanks to a command point, the Precursor's still alive with two wounds left. Then it's time for Nick's Tempestor to activate, and he takes a shot at my Skyblast.
Here he goes, hitting on threes. Oh, you would love to see that kind of roll. I might have missed once, Josh, but this gun is lethal 5+, so that is 3 crits going in against that Skyblast. He's got to be in trouble, man.
That's gnarly, right? Okay, retaining a cover save might not help me here, so I think we're just going to have to roll for it. Let's see if we can survive.
666. Oh, you tried real hard.
So
one
close.
Saved.
So close.
And that is one obliterated Skyblast.
That is one Skyblast Skyblasted.
The Tempestor's activation is over, but that earned Nick another kill grade. He's got another victory point. My leader moves into conceal and flies over to objective 3, because we're going to take that back.
My gunner's going to operate next, and with his plasma carbine, he's going to scramble up to the top of this building and take a good firing position right here. Now, that does get me quite close to your neutron fallout token, right?
It does, and as soon as you move within 2 inches of it, you actually take D3 damage as you breathe it all in.
Fine, he can take it. Oh, it's the big 3 damage. Okay, all right. Okay, that's not gone well, I'll admit. And it probably wasn't a great idea to let off a supercharged plasma carbine shot at that swarm guard right next to that neutron fallout marker. I've done no damage either. I just didn't get the hits. And worse, I failed the hot roll as well, taking 4 more damage. That means that gunner is down to 1 wound left. Next time they activate next to that marker, they're just going to die.
So I'm going to counteract with the Swarm Guard, because you've still got a model left to activate.
Yes, very good.
So we're going to use that Flamer and see if we can't get another kill.
Yeah, I'm in trouble. That Precursor is bracing. That's another great roll, Josh.
It is, yeah. So that's another 4 hits.
Well, Josh, there's absolutely no way my Precursor can survive this, but I'm going to roll the dice anyway, just for the sake of spite. I've managed to save a few, but yeah, I've been burned alive. They guarded that central objective, but no longer. Josh, that's the end of the turning point, of course. A great one, too. It's been brutal. Yeah. But I still hold objectives 1 and 2 for the Imperium.
And I only hold objective 3 still for the greater good.
So 2 victory points for me, 1 for you, but it's all to play for, isn't it? So the score to the end of turning point 3, it's 7-5 to the Tempestus Aquilons. Can the Vespa bring it back? Turning point 3 has seen the Tempestus Aquilons' plan of taking and holding the objectives really come into fruition, with the Vespa having to react and take back objective number 3. Now, we might be on an equal kill grade, but plenty of the Tempestus Aquilons' models are really, really badly injured, maybe even on 1 wound left. So there'll be a few more kills in turning point 4. Can Josh bring it back? Here we go.
Here you go, Josh. Turning point 4. This matters so much.
Comes down to this. And we've got it!
You've got it, and I rolled a 5!
So the Vespid are going to keep that momentum, and we're going to take priority this turn.
Yeah, fair enough.
Thanks to my oversight drone and my neurostimulants, I get 3 communion points.
Now it's time to see if that neutron fragment can finish off that servo sentry.
You wouldn't dare. You've been so good.
Let's see what we can do.
He's taking 3 damage. That is going to kill that sentry. Destroyed it.
This time, I won't spend any command points in the strategy phase. I have some tricks up my sleeve. But don't forget, aerial agility is still active thanks to the commune ability on my strain leader. Nick uses Eye Above to detect my shade strain and my strain leader. First to activate, my shade strain introduces Nick's gunfighter to its claws.
It's a great roll.
It's a good roll as well. Somewhat wasted. But yeah, my gunfighter has been slain.
This puts me up a kill grade, and my Vespid shade strain then dashes out of line of sight so I can keep that operative safe.
Josh, I've not got many options left here, and I'm going to activate this gunner here. But the second I do activate that gunner, I know I take damage from the neutron fallout.
You do, yeah.
This model's only got 1 wound left. Don't bother rolling the dice. It's a minimum of 1. He activates and is slain immediately by the rad token.
And chokes up in a neutron cloud.
It's time to spend that command point as my Vespid strain leader uses darting flight to move over to the central objective and secure it.
I've only got 1 model left on the board. It's looking a bit bleak, but that one model is my leader, the Tempestor, the most heroic of all. So he activates, and first up, I used a firefight ploy, Progena, to heal himself back up a few wounds. Then he's feeling so much better that he drew his chainsword, revved it up, and has charged headlong into Josh's strain leader for a leader-on-leader fight. Oh, Josh, you love to see it. I've got 2 crits over this side. Now, my leader is a Tempestus veteran. I'm going to use the command reroll here for free. I'm going to take this dice here.
Are you going to try to do even more damage?
Even more. Okay, so another hit as well.
Oh, so it's not looking good.
I'm going to start off the sequence here with my 4. I'm just going to block your 4. Oh. So no fun for you, sir.
Yeah, no damage from the Vespid.
And these 2 sixes are coming through for 5 damage apiece.
Oh, no.
I think that cuts me an 80.
He's only got 10 health.
He's dead.
Oh,
kill
no.
Kill him. He's gone.
What a hero.
He's got one APL left, Josh, and I'm going to aim his bolt pistol up here at your horrible swarm guard.
This dude wants Vespid blood.
I'm going to take him down. Okay, it's not a great roll, but it is going to be three hits going through, Josh.
Ooh, that hitting on threes is real good.
It's pretty good. You can, of course, retain one dice for the cover you're in.
Yep, so I'll retain one for cover, and let's see if we can make some five ups. And yes, we do can. With a double six.
Good work, sir. What a roll.
All right, the Vespid Swarm Guard has had enough. It's time to get revenge and point that flamer right back at the Tempestor.
Oh, it's a great roll, Josh.
It is. It's four hits.
Oh, no. Four plus save my carapace armor. I'm going to do these one at a time for dramatic
effect. Oh, of course. Of
Here
course.
We go.
Let's see them.
Okay,
it's a fail.
It's a bad start. I'll give you that.
Oh, it's another fail. A second.
Don't worry, though. The Emperor's with me. The last one will be a pass on a four plus. Here we go.
It's another fail.
That's another fail. That means he's taken all three hits and the other one as well that I couldn't say.
That's 12 damage.
He's been roasted alive. He is now a pile of ashes on the floor of Vulcus.
With the Tempestor dead, we moved up another kill grade. So I thought I'd move my oversight drone over just to confirm it all for the Tau folks at home.
So that's the end of the turning point, Josh, and you've managed to capture back these two objectives from me. Very well done.
We have.
So two victory points for you and one for me on the crit op. But
yep. But I think I actually finished the game on a higher kill grade than you,
you
Nick,
do.
Which
you've wiped
I believe
out.
Is going to make this a Vespid victory.
Well done,
Put
man.
It
great
there.
Game.
The Imperials have been slaughtered, and Vulcus is back under the control of the Tau Empire.
Look how happy you are about that, man. I'm just as unhappy over here. What a great game. That was a really cool game, man. I like the fact that we both had different plans from the start. I was all about the crit ops. I was trying to catch the objectives. At one point, I held all three, but that wasn't your plan, was it?
No, we were kill ops from day one. It turns out you can't hold objectives that well if you're dead.
So true. Those neutron weapons do terrible damage to the human body, it turns
out. They're pretty rad, aren't they?
Oh, Josh. Dude, what a great game. Thanks, man.
Yeah, good game.